Good morning, students. Let's start with module 2, probabilistic analysis and randomized algorithm. Probabilistic analysis deals with analyzing algorithms based on probability. Now, an algorithm is said to be randomized in behavior if the output produced is dependent on the random generator. Let's discuss the first problem statement, that is hiring problem. The scenario is as follows. A manager is hiring an assistant with the help of an agency. Now, the strategy for selection is as follows. That is, we assume that here the agency is sending a candidate per day. The manager will hire a new candidate if he finds the new person is better than his current assistant. In effect, whenever he hires a new candidate, he needs to fire his current assistant. The pseudocode for this problem statement is as follows. Here, n is the number of candidates to be interviewed. Out of this n, some m candidates will be hired. Now, we initialize the variable best with a value 0, indicating that there is a dummy candidate. Okay, when we interview a candidate, we will always compare this candidate with the value that is there in the best. So, in effect, we are comparing the candidate I with the current assistant. Now, if we find that he is better, he will be hired and the best will be reset, will be set with the value I. In effect, hiring is taking place and firing of the current assistant is also taken place. Now, what is the objective of this problem statement? The objective of this problem statement is to reduce the cost that is associated with hiring and firing. Okay, now let's discuss the total cost. The total cost associated can be divided into two parts. There is a cost associated with interviewing. By default, we need to interview n candidates sent by the agency. After this n, some n candidates will be hired. So here, CI represents the cost of interviewing and CH represents the cost of hiring. Now, let us discuss the worst case that can happen. The agency is sending candidates in increasing order of quality. That is, let's discuss this worst case with an example. Here, we have 5 candidates in hand. So, CI represents the candidate, right? So, here, rank I represents the quality of a candidate, per candidate, okay? It has also been listed up. Now, here our agency, the worst case, is sending them in increasing order of quality. What happens here? So, candidate 1, when he is interviewed, the manager will hire him, okay? So, hiring take place. When he meets a second candidate with a good rank, so obviously he needs to fire this candidate and hire this second candidate. Likewise, the process of hiring and firing take place for each and every candidate in sequence. And towards the end, he needs to hire the fifth candidate. Okay, now what is the total cost here? Okay, so the total cost here turns out to be NCH plus NCI. Okay, so what is our objective here? Our objective is to reduce this parameter. Here, instead of M, it is equal to N. Now, in this problem, as per the strategy that we have discussed, there is no control over the order in which the candidates are sent for interview. So, a solution is to randomize the input distribution and apply probabilistic analysis. Okay. So, here we assume that the candidates will appear in random order. Rather than the agency is sending a candidate per day, okay, what we will do? We will ask the agency to provide a list of candidates. Here, the agency can hide the rank. Now the manager will call the candidates in random order. Okay, when the input is randomized, our actual running time is equal to the expected running time. Now let us discuss a new term, indicator random variable. Now indicator random variable helps us to convert the probabilities to expectations and vice versa. Indicator random variable is denoted as IA. IA is equal to 1 if event A occurs, or C and 0 otherwise. Let's take the example of coin toss to understand the term indicator random variable in detail. Here XH, okay, here it represents the indicator random variable, okay, and IXH, so XH is equal to IH, okay, so here I can say it is the expectation that a head occurs while tossing a coin. Okay, this XH is equal to my indicator random variable, okay, which is equal to 1 if my head occurs while tossing, and 0 otherwise. Now in a flip, we know that expectation of this head occurring is equal to the expectation of this indicator random variable, which is equal to 1 into probability of H plus 0 into probability of tail. Okay, so in effect, the expectation of this head occurring is equal to 1 by 2. Now we need to discuss a small lemma. Given a sample space S and event A, okay, XA represents the indicator random variable. Now the expectation of this XA is equal to the probability of A. Now let us consider N flips. So here, capital X is equal to the summation of XI over 1 to N. Now applying expectation on both the sides, we find that expectation of this random variable X is equal to this expectation of the summation of XI. Okay, now according to the linearity of expectations, we can see that it is equal to summation of I is equal to 1 to N upon 1 by 2. So now it is, in effect, we can say that it is 1 by 2 and summation of 1 by 2 N times, which is equal to N by 2. Now let us analyze the hiring problem with this IRV that we have studied just now. Here capital X represents the random variable, which is nothing but the number of times we need to hire a new assistant. So capital X is equal to the summation of XI. What is this XI here? It is our indicator random variable, which is equal to 1 if candidate I is higher and 0 otherwise. As per the lemma that we have discussed, E of XI is equal to probability of hiring the candidate I. And please remember that the ith candidate is higher if and only if the ith candidate is better than all the previous candidates. Now, what is the probability of hiring a candidate I? It is equal to 1 by I. In effect, we can say the expectation of hiring the ith candidate is equal to 1 by I. Now, what is the expectation of hiring the candidates? It is equal to the expectation of hiring N candidates. So in effect, we will have to applying the linearity of expectations, we find that it's a summation of 1 by I over when I varies from 1 to N. It is equal to log N plus big O of 1. So from where did we got this value? For that, we need to discuss the harmonic series. The harmonic series HN is equal to 1 plus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 3 etc. till 1 by N. Okay, the summation of this harmonic series is equal to summation of 1 by I when I ranges from 1 to N, which is equal to log N plus big O of N. Now what did we concluded here that we need to hire log n people out of the n people that we have interviewed. So in effect, our total cost is reduced from n to log n.